I work at the Museum Association, talking to a lot of museums about this, and I think it's of a lot of interest to the people. I have heard a lot about augmented reality, but I haven't really seen it in action before, so it's nice to come and look at it and see how it works.
So it's a very big idea, actually, and it's coming of age. The new thing about this project is they're doing it indoors, because most of the current technologies use outdoor GPS sensing and image recognition of scenes, but this is able to do it more sensitively indoors in quite small areas.
The underlying technology is immensely important, because strategically the ability to be able to engage newer audiences, to bring more content in, to be able to use as an educational tool, and one of the most important things is the capacity to identify who is doing what, and therefore build a community of supporters, is absolutely essential for the future of galleries and a lot of other arts organisations.
I can see it as a sort of a standard thing that you would have in a gallery, and I can see how it could be used by different age groups as well. I can see with children and young people that they'd actually be really happy to be going around and doing that.
The potential is enormous. There's nothing that is a major obstacle in technology. There are little things which have got to be addressed in this area, but there's nothing that's a real problem in the underlying technology.
I think it was great, and just to change the way that you see, you know, a gallery that's just full of paintings, but for people who aren't really into their art, this really helps to bring a lot of these things alive and the story behind them.
It is quite an exciting technology. I think there's a lot of work still to do, especially for us, because we are a National Trust property where all our interesting things are furniture, basically. So we need the next stage of the project, which is 3D mapping, for it to work for us, I think, probably. But yes, there's lots of potential.
I think we were slightly nervous that some of our older visitors might not engage with the technology, but actually what we found was they loved it. They found it very easy, very user-friendly, and it gave them an enormous kind of added value to the experience. So, it's been really positive for us.
I think the layering of images is quite interesting, and I can see how that can be used. But the best bits, actually, were where it's overlaid with music and with video, and it seemed to work really, really well for oral history. And one of the things that is good is actually then you can kind of, after you've pointed, you can actually move away and you've got the oral history, you've got the music there, and you can actually move around the gallery.